The Atlanteans.
January 4, 2016, channeled by Vanessa Priest.
Greetings, brothers and sisters of Earth. We are the Atlanteans, and yes, we're aware of communications or channeled messages regarding the Atlantean priests, who misused their powers and led to the destruction of the great civilization known as Atlantis. Let us be reintroduced, for we are of New Atlantis. We, the beings of New Atlantis, exist in another reality, one which you would deem to be known as the future from your linear time perspective. We bring you the fondest of greetings in this the new year of the Gregorian calendar. We have much to say here as we ready your world to ensure that there is no paradox in the founding of our own. Our world, which is really the real world or universe, is currently a utopian society that you would deem to call heaven. All beings, dimensions, time, realities, and universes peacefully coexist in the harmonious loving reality known as Atlantis. Our channel Vanessa has been told of the plan for our landing on your world, in the time just before what is known as spring in the Northern Hemisphere. In the second week of March 2016, we will make our landing on your planet alongside the beings known as the Galactic Federation of Light, in order to raise consciousness, teach, guide, lead, as well as to free you of your long-standing slavery to the beings known as the Dark Ones, or the Anunnaki. Vanessa is the one we would call an emissary between Earth and Atlantis, for she was created by Gaia to answer Gaia's prayer, for a resolution to the slavery her children find themselves in, whether they are aware of it or not. My name is of no importance. What is important is that we are coming into a time of great change and upheaval on your planet, which will pave the way for the new Earth of the fifth dimension, which is ultimately known as Atlantis. Because linear time exists on Earth and throughout the universe where she resides, a future timeline resulted, which is both a boon as well as a caution, for we could unravel the future, in theory, if the appropriate I's are not dotted and T's are not crossed, in accordance with the history laid down in our records. But, we would not be able to contact you, nor be channeled by one of you if this was going to happen, because the paradox would already be evident. Time is not a circle, it is cyclical, but not a circle, so there is no folding back in on itself where paradox could happen. Paradox is merely a theory of the linear time world. Some elements of the future are set to a great extent, such as the existence of our utopian society, or a heaven where all beings live in harmony. But the details of how that truly manifests is for you all, along with us, your brethren, to decide. I cannot stress enough how important it is that you focus on the manifestation of your dreams for your planet, your people, and yourselves, because they can all come true. For the Creator of all that is has deemed that the dreams of the people of Earth become the foundation for New Earth or New Atlantis. You all have suffered much. As a thank you from heaven and a congratulations for a mission well accomplished, you will have your wishes and dreams come true, if you imbue them with the emotion of love and focus on them regularly. This can be done in meditation and/or visualization. We are of the light. Yet we also maintain the perspective of a people of the future. You are in the past. The present is an elusive place whereby the future is built by what you do, think, feel, act, etc. We are here to guide you through the process of building what you want, from where you are, to where you would like to be. Nothing has been left to chance by the Creator of all that is. The Anunnaki are in the twilight of their power and position on Earth, and new Earth will be born, it is inevitable. The fifth dimension is calling, you have only to heed the call to be free, and we will help. We will support this process in every conceivable way possible. Heaven's angels are always available to be called upon, as are we, the Atlanteans. We love you all beyond measure, and to prove this, we are going back in time to be present at the birth of our civilization, at the risk of undoing elements of it, to facilitate your growth and rebirth into the fifth dimension. You will be, and are being supported beyond all others, for Earth and her people are the great hope of all creation. What can you expect when we land? A great question. Let us now answer. The unexpected is what you can expect. Channels can only bring in truth to the extent that their egos will allow, that the people of Earth are ready to receive, and truthfully there is only so much that we can bring in that you can relate to, for, we exist in a time where there is no time. There is just what is. That's it. Our channel calls it true time, and it is. It truly is. If it can be measured, it's called not years, but cycles. There is no old age, there is no death. There is no pain, there is no suffering. Not only are these illusions as other channeled messages have reported, but our channel has had a powerful epiphany, whereby she has realized that death is none other than a limiting belief. A dangerous, seemingly powerful one, but a simple belief nonetheless. As is any belief in linear time. Within your DNA is the secret to immortality, but begin by disbelieving and releasing, if you can, this belief in death. As Vanessa knows, the divine does not interfere with free will, nor are there any exceptions to the application of the law of attraction, which some of you study. If you can attract success, money, love, health, etc. to yourself, you also can attract death, old age, pain, suffering and such, and you do. The divine follows the dictates of your free will, so if you decide on any level that you want death, death is what you will draw to you and experience. You were all created in the image and likeness of God, which means that the perfection of God is within you, as is the eternal nature of God, so how can you possibly die, unless you draw it to yourself on a conscious, subconscious, or unconscious level? The perfect cannot create imperfection. This is why the process of becoming your true self is one of remembering, not becoming. This is all for now. This is a powerful lesson and I hope you will apply it to your life, if you know how to, yet, or not. Just trust that your intention has power, because it does. Namaste, my friends, namaste.